What's up, guys? Mini PCs are very popular now, because for affordable money, you can get a pretty powerful computer for almost any task, including gaming. In this video, I want to tell you about the new Paladin WI6 Mini PC. Although it is positioned as an office computer, we will try to play some games on it. Perhaps the main feature of this mini PC is the Intel Twin Lake N150 CPU. This is an upgraded processor of the popular Intel N100 with a higher frequency of 3.6 GHz. Actually, we already tested a mini PC on this processor a few months ago, and to be honest, I didn't notice much better performance compared to the Intel N100 powered mini PC. But maybe the new Paladin WI6 will be better. It comes with 16 GB of RAM, 512 GB of SSD, and a Windows 11 operating system. This is a very budget mini PC, just about $150, but we will test it in detail for different tasks in this video. Let's start by unboxing it! So the new Paladin mini PC comes in this box. It has a company name and logo on the front. I didn't know what the logo means, but it looks and shimmers very nice. And there is a sticker on the back of the box with a computer name and information about manufacturer. So Paladin is a Chinese company, I have nothing against it, but we will check the mini PC for viruses later in this video. The package is standard for most mini PCs, such as the computer itself. Power adapter and power cable. HDMI cable, wall mount bracket, and user manual. So the first surprise was that my mini PC is black, but I expected it to be blue, like on the Amazon page. The Paladin WI6 is a very small and lightweight mini PC. Its dimensions are 133x112x34mm. The weight is 240 grams. It has a matte black plastic case, and only the front panel is glossy. The Paladin logo shines on the top panel. Talking about connectivity options, there is a 3.5mm headphone jack, USB Type-C port, two USB 3.2 ports, and a power button on the front. The back panel has two HDMI 2.0 ports, two USB 2.0 ports, a LAN port, and a DC power. So the mini PC has many USB ports, which is very convenient. The company also claims that this computer supports 4K triple screens display. You can use two HDMI and USB-C ports for connecting monitors. There is a sticker on the bottom of the mini PC with some technical information about it, as well as four rubberized feet and four bolts. Let's unscrew them and see what's inside. So we can see RAM and SSD drives here, but no fan. It is on the other side, under the board, and it is not easy to remove, so I cannot show it to you. As for the RAM and SSD disks, they both have stickers from Paladin, but I didn't find them on sale separately. Most likely, they are from another manufacturer, but I don't know which one. The mini PC comes with a 16GB DDR4 3200 RAM disk and 512GB M.2 2280 SATA disk. What's interesting is that this computer has only one RAM slot, so it probably supports maximum 16GB RAM. Alright, let's put the mini PC back together. Now we can turn it on and check the boot speed right away. The new Paladin mini PCs start up in just 15 seconds. This is really fast, because the previous mini PC we tested on the AMD Ryzen 7 CPU took almost 30 seconds to boot. So we are greeted by the familiar Windows 11 Pro operating system. By the way, as soon as I connected to the internet, the mini PC started downloading and installing software updates. It took quite a while to finish, several hours. In the end, you get the latest version of the activated Windows 11 Pro with the Windows Store, Microsoft 365, and other apps. By the way, let's check the mini PC for viruses. The malware was found on this computer. I thought that only Ace Magic mini PCs came with the pre-installed viruses, but the Paladin WI6 also has them. You can quarantine them in your antivirus. But it is better to reinstall Windows. We have a tutorial on how to do this quickly on our channel Tech Brothers. Okay, let's keep talking about the main feature of this mini PC, the new Intel N150 processor. This is a new CPU from the end of 2024, and it is meant for entry-level laptops, tablets, and mini PCs. On the CPU Benchmark website, we can see its multi-thread rating and single-thread rating, such as 5530 points and 1922 points, respectively. The clock speed of the Intel N150 processor is 0.8 GHz, while the turbo speed is 3.6 GHz. By the way, we can see here that this CPU supports maximum 16 GB of RAM, so we cannot install more than this mini PC has now. In addition, the Intel N150 CPU is advertised as an improved Intel N100, but we can see in the charts that it is only slightly better. I have already said that the Paladin WI6 mini PC has a built-in cooling fan, and this processor does not really need one because it has only 6 watts typical TDP. When I used it, the computer even ran at less than 1 watt in standby mode. The typical TDP is around 4-6 watts, and the maximum TDP when running the stress test is 10 watts. So this is a very energy efficient mini PC. As for the fan noise, I almost didn't hear it, only 38 decibels in normal use. At maximum processor load. However, if you put your hand on the side of the computer, you will feel warm air coming out, which means the fan is running. So let's go back to the SSD disk some more. I run program to check the SSD health, and it also says this drive is from the Paladin. Let's test its read and write speeds. So it has 550 megabits per second read and 478 megabits per second write speed. That's pretty slow SSD. I would recommend installing some better one with a speed of 3000 megabits per second or even more. Now let's run the benchmark tests. In the Geekbench 6, the new Paladin WI6 mini PC has 1039 points in single core test and 2287 points in multi core test. The Cinebench R23 also tests single core and multi core performance, and they are 965 points and 2932 points, respectively. In the Passmark performance test benchmark, we can see not only CPU mark, but also 2D mark, 3D mark, memory mark, and disk mark. As for the PC Mark 10 benchmark, the new Paladin mini PC has a 33/18 overall score there. As you can see, that is almost half the result of office laptops. Finally, we can run the 3D Mark benchmark to check the GPU performance of this computer. The Paladin mini PC has 474 overall score in TimeSpy, which is a little above average result. And a 1355 overall score in FireStrike. Overall, the benchmark test results are pretty low, but expected from the Intel N150 processor. However, the 3D Mark suggests that it might be possible to play games on this mini PC. Let's give it a try. You know I have installed only a few games on this mini PC, because it is not positioned as a gaming computer. These games are Dota 2, Counter-Strike 2, Asphalt Legends Unite, and the Finals. Let's play them without my commentary. So what can I say? In general, all games run except the Finals. I waited for a long time for it to launch, but never did. Dota 2 and Asphalt are very comfortable to play. As for the Counter-Strike 2, it is better to choose 720p resolution in the settings. But even so, it will slow down. So if you really want to, you can play some games on the Paladin WI6 mini PC, but it is not meant for gaming. According to the manufacturer, this computer is designed for office and home tasks. Let's try it out in a few of these scenarios. First, I want to play 4K video on YouTube. The mini PC has no problems with this. The video starts quickly and plays without any lags. We can also test performance with many tabs open in the browser. So we have 10 tabs open with our videos in the Google Chrome, and I can switch between them and watch videos without any problems. By the way, the Paladin WI6 mini PC supports Wi-Fi 5 and Bluetooth 5.2. You can also use a 2.5 gigabits RJ45 LAN port for wired connection. I used a wireless Wi-Fi connection to the internet, and the download and upload speed was just over 100 megabits per second. This is the maximum transmission rate from my ISP. You can also use the new Paladin mini PC for different office tasks. It already has Microsoft 365 pre-installed with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and other apps from Microsoft. I even tried running Adobe Premiere Pro with a 4K video project. If your project is not very big and you only need to make a few edits to the video, then you can do this on the Paladin Mini PC. By the way, exporting a 1-minute video in 4K resolution took only 1 minute and 9 seconds. So overall, the Paladin WI6 is a good budget mini PC for simple home and office tasks. You can even play some games on it, like Dota 2. I like its compact design and the large number of ports. So you can even connect 3 monitors using 2 HDMI ports and USB Type-C port. As a mini PC has a built-in fan, but it works almost silently. It is quiet and energy-efficient computer. If I were to use this mini PC at home or in the office, the first thing I would be to change the SSD to a faster one and reinstall Windows, because the Paladin WI6 comes with pre-installed malware. You know, I am not even surprised by this, because many mini PCs have viruses out of the box. You just need to reinstall the operating system, and your computer will be clean. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon!